from spitting on an innocent girl in the crowd to throwing a man out of the window at a bar. It seems like Charles Barkley has had some shockingly controversial moments that went viral. For starters, his anger issues have only made things worse for him and everyone around him. From threatening to hit a female reporter to actually throwing someone out of the window, he seems to have a hard time controlling himself. Like the incident at the bar in Orlando, the Hall of Famer says that he threw the man out just because he was bothering him, and he didn't even seem to regret it either. Instead, he claims the man attacked him first by throwing ice in his face, so if anything, this was more like self-defense rather than a full-blown attack. Other than that, he still claims the man got what he deserved and that he has zero regrets about the incident. On top of that, he said he's gonna do the exact same thing again with anyone who tried to bother him. Not to mention, he's also pretty vocal about his political inclinations, which only makes this more complicated. Back in 2019, the 1993 MVP threatened to hit Alexi McCammond all because of a difference in opinion regarding politics. And when she tried to fire back, he said that she couldn't take a simple joke. Really? It just seems like he tried to cover up his inexcusable threats. Sure, he went on to apologize for his insensitive remarks, but still insisted that he was just trying to make a harmless joke and nothing more, although many would still find it pretty hard to believe. Not to mention, his political opinions can be pretty controversial too. He literally defended the cops over killing Breonna Taylor, and needless to say, it sparked a lot of backlash from fans and the media. If you didn't know, Taylor was a 26-year-old woman who was fatally shot by the cops, and all of this happened back in March 2020 in Louisville. The police officers involved, who were responsible for the incident, weren't punished appropriately. That's exactly why people were furious about the injustice. This moment sparked the Black Lives Matter protests, and well, that is a whole other video.
Breonna Taylor's life mattered! Say her name!
Alongside this, the whole incident occurred around the same time as the pandemic hit. As for Charles, he spoke in favor of the police officers instead, insisting that her death wasn't as comparable to some of the other recent deaths by police brutality.
Number one, I'm sorry the young lady got killed, but you can't compare that to the murder of George Floyd. Those are two different animals. I think that's the problem what we have being black on television. See, black people think we have to agree with them all the time.
I just gotta say, it's not a competition when it comes to incidents like these, and his insensitive remarks have only added to the pain. Having said that, some of his actions even managed to land him in jail. A couple of years ago, he was arrested for drunk driving on New Year's Eve. Not only that, but it turns out he also ran a red light on the exact same day. And thanks to that, he got himself thrown in jail for 5 whole days. Now, he was pretty honest when the police caught him, and when asked why he was driving so fast anyway, he said he was racing to a woman's house to receive, in his words, the best oral sex I've ever had. Later, he went on to apologize for his behavior and called it unacceptable. But that doesn't change the fact that the incident still left its mark on the NBA legend's career. Not to mention, he got arrested for drunk driving again about 4 months later. After spending some time locked up in jail, he says it taught him a valuable lesson. Plus, he's thankful that no one got hurt during either of these two incidents. While he claimed that he had learned his lesson, this was short-lived. Barkley chose to blame the idea of hypocrisy in sporting events. The notion that they serve alcohol at every single one of them, even though a bunch of people are gonna have to drive themselves home. Honestly, he was just trying to save himself with that. Because at the end of the day, you're responsible for how much you're drinking and when.
Thank God I've never killed anybody. So I actually thought that was a learning experience for me. Because I think people sometimes think when you screw up, it can be a good thing.
Having said that, this was still one of the least controversial things he's done. Not to mention, he likes to cover everything up by calling it a joke. Or maybe that's just how his sense of humor works. One of his most controversial jokes was, "That's why I hate white guys." At this point, the Chuckster was known for blasting his opinion first, and worrying about the consequences second. When a German reporter tried to get his opinion on so-called NBA groupies, it seemed like it was the wrong time to get him for an interview because he dropped the F-bomb, claiming that the groupie thing is a sick subject and these journalists need to get a life. That's when he followed it up with his controversial statement, but it didn't take long for him to cover it up by saying that he was just messing around. Obviously, the media still went off, and all the major networks were trying to make a story out of this. Was he racist after all? Well, he didn't think of it as a very big deal. In fact, he claimed that the journalists were just trying to make a controversial story out of a bad taste joke, not to mention the sensitivity when it comes to race. Sure, he tried to cover it up by pointing out the relationships he's got with people from the same race, but one simple thing could have wrapped this whole story up. He just needs to be more careful with his words, but it doesn't seem like that's happening anytime soon, and this wasn't the first time he made a racist comment. His comments about unintelligent blacks got him a lot of criticism as well. Back at the Afternoons with Anthony Gargano and Rob Ellis radio show, during the segment, Charles mentioned that unintelligent blacks in American society are practically brainwashed, and that makes them put street smarts over success. Not only that, but during a separate instance, he also claimed that he's allowed to use the N-word with whomever he wants. Basically, he believes that he's got a pass for racial slurs thanks to his ethnicity, and America isn't gonna dictate to him what's appropriate and what's not. At this point, in one way or another, he seemed to have offended a lot of different fans and people within the industry with his outrageous comments, and it was time for a reaction. So the sports world decided to react to his controversy. His comments on the black community and gay people went viral quicker than you'd think. Here's what he said exactly. One thing that's always disappointed me is that black people are the worst when it comes to treating gay people, and that didn't sit well with a lot of people on social media. In fact, sports fans went as far as saying that the media is taking advantage of his self-hate to spread anti-blackness. Meanwhile, another pointed out the fact that white men were shooting up gay clubs while Charles was tap dancing on CNN with his insensitive comments. All fans wanted him to do was support gay people without attacking a specific ethnicity. Having said that, the entire comment came about after the shooting at an LGBTQ bar in Colorado Springs, so some people find it understandable that he'd be disappointed. Having said that, he's a pretty influential figure, and that's why he needs to be more careful about what he says in public, especially when he's asserting a few facts in interviews, because he's not the only person getting in trouble, especially when it comes to racism. At some point, fans also claim that he's pretty much immune to controversy and nothing's gonna affect him anymore. It looks like he's gonna stick with his controversial statements for now. Does he even really deserve his success? What do you guys think? Is he just misunderstood? Or is Charles Barkley just as bad as I've made him seem? Here were some of Charles Barkley's most outrageous moments.
They got mad at you in Baltimore when it seemed like you were defending the police.
Well,
it took a lot of heat there.
And I had no problem with that. First of all, I've always defended the police, but that doesn't mean I think they're always right. First of all, we need the police, especially in the black community.